there. Today, I'm going to share with you how you can count the number of days in Data Studio from the date range selection dynamically. I have seen some of you raise these questions in Reddit and also comments on other YouTube channels to ask for help. But so far, I haven't seen anyone address this. So I thought of giving it a try and here am I sharing my solution with y'all. There are two steps involved. First, you need to generate the dates in Google Sheets. And then you need to import the list of dates into Data Studio. The second step is to create a calculated field in Data Studio. Actually, we can do it without creating a new metric, but I'm doing this just in case you need the number of days in a metric to calculate something for your use case. So let's get started. To generate the dates, we need to use the sequence formula. It will return us a list of sequential numbers. As for the parameters, you can see that only the part rows are required. The rest are optional. For our date generations today, you need to understand rows and start part. For example, if you want to generate numbers from 1 to 10, your rows input should be 10. And then the rest will leave it at 1. If let's say we want to start generating the numbers from number 6, then we can specify the third input, which is start to number 6. So with this concept in mind, let's start to generate the dates. You need to open a new spreadsheet. Then we need to specify the start date and the end date. Before we proceed further, let's give a name to this file. Here, I also have an extra step to add a data validation for the date field. So just double click and you will see a calendar date pop up. For the start date, you will need to specify the very first date in your data set. For example, if your sales start from 1st of Jan, then you can key in the exact date in this cell. And the end date, we are going to set it to the current date. So the list of dates that we generate here will be expanding every day without any manual editing. So just type in equal sign and today. Alright, the next step is a bit more complicated, but don't worry, we will go through step by step to do this together. So now we will key in the formula sequence. For the rows, we will need to indicate the difference between end date and start date. Also remember to plus 1 to get the entire date range. For column, we can leave it as 1, whereas for start, we need to indicate the start date. Lastly, we can put step as 1. Now we have all the dates generated in a number format. Our last step is to convert the dates from number format to date format. If you prefer a simple method, select the entire column and then go to format and select date. For me, I would prefer a more automated way, which is to convert the number to date within a formula. To convert it to date, just type in to date formula and you will realize that the values now return only one of the date. To fix that, we can add array formula. So now we have the full set of dates generated. If you want this to be more neat, like what I do here, that you have one page for the setting and one page for all the dates that you generated. What you can do is to move this formula to the next page. Before that, let's rename the current page as settings and then add one more page to edit this formula. We just need to add the page title and an exclamation mark in front of all the cell reference. So this is how we do it. Settings, exclamation mark. So here you go, we have all the dates over here. Let's add a column name and name the page to dates. So now we're going to import the data set that we just generated. Go to Google Sheets and click on by me and select the document that you just created. So for the worksheet, make sure you select the dates one instead of the settings. In case you mix it up in just one document, like one page, you can specify the range over here. So now I'm just going to click Add to add this data set into the report. The very first step I'm going to do is to add this date range control and add a scorecard. Okay, let me set the default date range to today and then we will test this out. So let's try this out. Let's say I select 1st of July to the current date, we should get 4 days. Yes, it's right. So let's say I select from last month, 1st of June until today. It's 34 days. Actually, until this step, we have already completed our mission today, which is to calculate the number of days from the date range selector. But as promised, we will create a new calculated field using count this thing, just in case you need this count for your calculation. So what we're going to do now is to create a field. Let's name it as count date. And then we are going to enter the formula count this thing and add the date here. Click save and finished. Refresh. And drag in the formula to this metric. So now it should function as what we have just now. You can use this to calculate. So let's say you want to calculate the number of day over 365 days. So I'm just renaming it as percentage of days. Then click update and finish. Refresh this one. And then I'm going to change these to percent. Click view. So let's say I select maybe last quarter, you should get 25%. That's how we can utilize this metric for your calculation. That's all for today. I hope this sharing helps you with your reporting in Data Studio. If you happen to use this for your report, I'm extremely excited to know what use case you use this for. Thank you and see you next time. Bye!